Para mí la característica principal, como no puede ser de otra forma, es la preparación, que sean buenos profesionales indudablemente.
The main characteristic is obviously the preparation. A national coach needs to be a good professional, having had a good career and experience. But above all, they need to keep calm. You need to know that you can't do in 10 days what a regular coach would do in 2 months. And that's very important, to have the capability not to try and do in 1 week what they may have done at a different team in 3 months of work. That makes a huge difference. I have no doubt that a lot of fantastic club coaches would have trouble to become national team coaches. To be a national coach is very special and brings with it a huge responsibility, because at the end of the day, in any category, A teams or youth teams, you represent Spanish football everywhere, not only in the country but also at international level, and that's a big responsibility.
Representar al fútbol español en cualquier parte del mundo, tanto en el ámbito nacional como en el ámbito internacional, ¿no? Y eso es una gran responsabilidad. Y siempre lo he dicho, además, es que yo no he visto nunca una generación de talento tan grande, ¿no? Si España se pone a sumar hoy día, dice, pues dentro de los mejores porteros del mundo tenemos a tres, sí.
I always say it, I've never seen a generation so talented in my life. If you think about it, do we have three of the best goalkeepers in the world? The answer is yes. Do we have the best defenders in their position? That's also true. Think about the midfielders. We probably have the best three in the world. And up front we have the best striker in the history of Spanish national team, David Villa. We also have Torres, Iniesta, Xavi, Busquets, Xabi Alonso, Sergio Ramos, Piqué, Jordi Alba, Casillas, Valdés, Reina, Arbeloa, and they are all followed by a second line of players too, like Silva, Cesc, Cazorla, Mata. Young people coming and playing already in the best teams in the world. If you look at the Spanish team, line by line, all of their players are the best of the world in their position. And that proves the level we have.
De que si tú miras el equipo de España línea por línea y demarcación por demarcación, todos esos jugadores están dentro de los mejores jugadores del mundo en su puesto, ¿eh? Y eso habla del nivel, ¿no? Posiblemente hay es una situación pura y dura económica, ¿no? Presupuesto que manejan ambos clubes con lo que manejan a partir del tercero.
There's a huge difference. It's a pure and hard economic situation. They both have a bigger budget than the others. If you have a budget not too far from 600 million euros, competing with others of around 100 million, it's a big difference. It's not good for our league, the fact that you end up each season with more than 20 points difference between the first team and the third one. It can't be good.
27, 28 puntos de diferencia, 20 con respecto al tercero, ¿no? Yo creo que no puede ser bueno.